Hello guys, I hope you're well. So today we want to do something on spray coating using EDEM or discrete element modeling. As you know, whatever I do is available in EDEM user forum. So you have to actually buy the software. So I actually try to make some tutorials for the customers who are there and who can't interpret the data which is already there. So today we want to do, as I said earlier, we want to do spray coating. So here we want to save this project in this folder, particle spraying, but I also have my particle spraying DLL. This also can be found in EDEM user forum. So let me save this project. We save the project in that folder. So particle spraying, so we call it particle spraying example. So we start off by creating a bulk material. This is the spray material, so we rename it, call it spray material. This is the spray material. So under spray material, we want the following properties. The Poisson's ratio remains at 0.25. The density is 1000 kg per meters cubed. This one, shear modulus, you put at 1000 pascals, it will remain in red. So we can't do any interaction because we've not created any other particle, any other material or bulk material. So we add another bulk material called the tablet. So we call this tablet like that. And under tablet, we do the following. The Poisson's ratio remains as it is. The density, now we do it as 2000 kg per meters cubed. The shear modulus, let it be 1e^7, like that. Now here we can do the interactions. So under interactions, just let everything remain by default the way it is, 0.5 0.5 0.01. also we add another one, tablet and doublet, let it remain the way it is, nothing has changed. So also here we do spray and spray, nothing has changed. So under spray, we add a particle now. So we want it to be like that. So the physical radius should be 0.025 of a millimeter. That's the physical radius. And the size distribution, let us rename this to spray. Size distribution, we put it at random. Don't change anything. The way it is, and we scale by radius, not volume. Properties, we calculate. Calculate properties like that, and then we click save. So for tablet, we want to create four particles. So what you can do, you just add a particle like that. You can do one particle like that. And then we change the positions of X, Y, and Z. Okay? So we are going to change them, and we are going to do them in this format. So we should have five particles in the following way. So there's no contact radius here. So I have this 9.05 e^-5, like that, and then 4.94, it's minus 4.94 e^-5. And then 0.00021911. So we want to add another sphere. So we just add sphere, the second one, and so on now. So I'm going to fast forward this bit. Yes, now we are done. Now we have our tablet. So this is my tablet. This is the shape of my tablet. So actually you can import a template. You can import a drone template and populate it with these particles. So if you have a template, as you can see, it's just an example. So if you have a template, you can you can use it. So then we calculate as distribution, let it remain fixed, nothing, don't change anything here. So properties, you calculate the properties like that. Okay, so now the next thing that we need to do is to create the materials, the equipment material. So the equipment material, we can create steel. Let's create one, because you only need one. Let us call it steel with the following properties. Let Poisson's ratio remain like that, 0.25, and then density, put it as 8000. Shear modulus, put it like this, 8e/9, like that. Now the interactions, don't forget the interactions, let them remain as they are. It's not, no need to complicate things unless you have done the actual experiment. Remember, the equipment material is only applicable to when you are assigning the geometry. You don't need to have so many equipment materials, steel one, steel two, unless you want to assign it. So only put material that you will assign. Now we create our geometry. So we add a box, let's call it box. Rename, you can call it even container, like that. And then we change these dimensions, put 75 by 75 by 75. So you want a small one because it's just an example. So bring it closer, just click here on top, default will bring it closer. Then always save your work, always save your work, never forget that. Then we add a factory, here. Remember, this is physical, so if it is hollow in nature, like we have some space inside here, we can add a factory. But if it was only flat like a polygon and it's physical type, the type is physical, you will see that the factory part will not be active. So let us add factory. Here we don't want dynamic, so we want static. So we change factory type and rename this to static so that we don't forget. And then what we want here is for the tablets, you want them to remain stationary. We don't want the tablet to move or to fall. Okay, so this is what we do. You let it fill section, and then here at this point position we put cubic, and then we change the configuration. So we change into configuration, so we do like this. The start point 0, here is minus 20, so we change this one to 50. 5, then y is 5, z is 50, like that. And then we say okay. Is there anything else that you can change here? Now we want to create another particle, another geometry. So this is a polygon, like that. So we can call it the outlet or the nozzle outlet. So this is where the spray will be coming out from. Okay, so you can call it outlet. Let's just call it outlet. I don't know the exact name. So here we want a polygon. So a polygon of sides 20, and put sides 20, and then the length. So you can put length, then the radius, you can put it at 5 millimeters, like that. And then the surface, normally we want to change some things. So we can put this one as 1, and also this one, like that. And now we want to change some things here. We want to reposition it somewhere at the corner or somewhere on top. So we put 30 and top 30, like that. So we can put it like that. So you can decide even to put multiple of outlets so that they are here, or you can change the dimensions. So under this, you want to add a factory.